district, the new city mayor is a man who is relieved, especially after being successfully sworn in. Reports say Mr. Robert Kachebezi has a mountain of unsettled debts hanging over his head in more sinister fashion than the sword of Damocles. He told a congregation after his swearing in that a group of individuals believed to be moneylenders had rushed to Mbarara High Court to block the occasion.
The swearing-in ceremony for the Mbarara city mayor together with his councillors was attended by government officials and was presided over the Mbarara chief magistrate.
I, Kachebezi Robert Mugabe, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I shall faithfully exercise the function of the mayor of Mbarara City Council and shall uphold, preserve, protect, and defend the constitution and observe the laws of Uganda, and I shall protect the welfare of the people of this city. So help me God.
Thank you. Congratulations. You can.
While new mayor Robert Kachebezi read out his oath, the rest of the councillors swore in agreement, which disappointed the electorates who wanted to witness the eloquence of their elected leaders in the English language.
In the name of the Almighty, that I will be faithful and bear allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So much as we are deliberating on the issues pertaining this city, we should not forget the manifesto of NRM. Honorable members, I still call to order that personally as a speaker, we are there to bridge, I'm there to bridge the council and the technical team.
In his maiden speech, Kachebezi attacked his opponents who sought a court injunction to block his swearing in over unclear debts.
By yesterday, people were even at lawyers to put injunction on my swearing. What? What? Ngungi wakaru? Ngungi no? Oh, una kozi senamu nyaga? Which case now? I'm holy and pure.
Meanwhile, the newly sworn-in LC5 chairpersons for Hoima and Kakumiro have promised to prioritize commercialization of agriculture.
One of them is to fight and eradicate poverty from the community, at least from the 68% those who are in non-economy, non-cash economy, at least to reduce it to around 20.
And my priority in this term is specifically going to be on commercial production. Why commercial production? It is because Hoima, we have so many opportunities in oil and gas industry.
The Hoima Chief Magistrate David Sayuni, who presided over the swearing-in ceremony, asked leaders to ensure they serve the people who elected them into these offices.
Exercise of swearing-in new leaders went well in all the districts that they handled, right from Hoima City to Hoima District, to Chukuve, and then to Kadadi this morning and this afternoon.
Can we have?
Tomorrow I still have
In the east, the Iganga district chairperson Ezra Gabula was today sworn in. The swearing-in ceremony, which was presided over by the Iganga chief magistrate Zulai Kananteza, took place at the district headquarters. Gabula, who was accompanied by his two beaming wives, knelt to thank voters for entrusting him with the office.
Gabula Ezra, swear in the name of the Almighty God, solemnly affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
And finally, Kabarole District Chairperson Richard Rwabuhinga was also today sworn in for his third term of office as District Chairperson. Rwabuhinga, after taking oath, elected Stella Chiorampe as his deputy. He also appointed Milton Bahati as the Secretary for Production, Resty Balinda as Secretary for Education, and Peter Bazira as Secretary for Finance. The councillors also elected Timothy Ruweza as their Speaker and Stella Kemigambo as Deputy Speaker.